I'm Dr. John Iskander. Welcome to CDC's Beyond the Data. I'm here today with Dr. Barbara Gooch to discuss community water fluoridation. Barbara, could you, for our audience, orient us generally at first to what we mean by fluoridation or community water fluoridation?
Community water fluoridation is the adjustment of the fluoride content of drinking water for the prevention of tooth decay. Overall, most water contains fluoride, but it's generally at levels too low to prevent tooth decay. So after both public health and clinical research done during most of the 20th century, we learned that at about 1 part per million, or 1 milligram per liter of fluoride in water, carries in communities that added fluoride to their water to that level, had about a 50 to 60% reduction in tooth decay. Remember, at the time that community water fluoridation was first introduced, beginning in the 1940s, that was the main source of fluoride, the water supply.
So one essential benefit that you've just talked about is prevention of tooth decay.
Exactly.
Are there other, for example, economic benefits that we receive from water fluoridation?
Well, yes, there certainly have been economic analyses. And these generally are going to look at the costs of implementing a water fluoridation program and the costs of the dental treatment that's prevented by instituting such a program. And these have generally found that community water fluoridation is not only cost effective, but also saves costs. One published estimate is that for every dollar spent on community water fluoridation programs, $38 are saved in dental treatment costs annually.
What have we learned over the years about adverse effects that might be associated with community water fluoridation?
Well, that's a very good question, because we do get a lot of inquiries about adverse effects. And multiple reviews by panels of scientists over the years and also public health professionals have assured that not only is community water fluoridation beneficial, but it's safe. We've had several recent reviews, and those have concluded that the only perhaps termed unwanted effect of fluoride in water at the levels used for community water fluoridation would be dental fluorosis. And let me just take a minute to explain what dental fluorosis is. Dental fluorosis is a change in the appearance of the tooth enamel. So it's a change in the appearance of the tooth surface. In the United States, most dental fluorosis is very mild or mild. It's barely detectable to most individuals. It appears as white spots or flecks. And generally, it is detectable by your dental professional.
So we have a public health intervention which is cost beneficial, mm-hmm. Has no evidence of serious adverse health effects. People may be wondering, though, compared to when fluoride was originally instituted in water supplies, we now have other sources of fluoride. What should people know about fluoridation in the modern environment where there is fluoride from other sources?
Well, there are other sources of fluoride that have become available since community water fluoridation was introduced in the U.S. And these, of course, are commonly known. Fluoride toothpaste is used daily by most persons in the U.S., fluoride mouth rinses and supplements. But the available data indicates that there is still an additional benefit from drinking fluoridated tap water. The most recent data indicates that you have an additional benefit of about a 25% reduction in tooth decay from community water fluoridation.
Very good information. For people in our audience who want more information, what's a reliable source for them to consult?
Well, I would turn to the CDC's website. That's cdc.gov/oralhealth. And you will find additional information on fluoridation and other oral health topics.
Thank you very much, Barbara. Please join us next month for another edition of Beyond the Data.